SEO audits are like the bread and butter to an SEO because it's looking at site-wide issues, whereas in content marketing it's more specific around keywords and topic themes. There are a lot of things involved in SEO audits, but don't worry, we're not going to bog you down with a range and different factors involved. Instead, we're going to break it down in an easy, digestible way. Hey there, it's Gerald here from Similarweb, the official measure of the digital world. In today's video, we're going to be taking you through SEO audits, and we're going to be looking at what are SEO audits, what ranking factors are involved in SEO audits, and how do you get started with the implementation of SEO audit findings. SEO audits are reviews into your website's performance. So for example, in an e-commerce website, this would be looking at your product pages, your blog, and category pages, for example. It may look at each of those individually or collectively, depending on how big your website is. And you may actually have a lot of interactions with the website developer. Let's look first of all at content ranking factors. For instance, duplicated content. Where else do I have the same content on my website? This is known as duplicated content. You want to make sure that your content isn't duplicated, and this includes metadata. For example, titles, descriptions, and headings. You don't want to use the same titles, descriptions, and headings on multiple pages because it's not unique. The second type of ranking factors are technical ranking factors. For instance, valid code. It's sometimes called HTML markup. But crucially, you want to make sure you're asking the web developer, does my website align with W3C standards? And also, does my website use schema? If so, which schema markup is used, and making sure that you actually have no errors when it comes to schema. Also, you want to make sure that your website is being crawled. So for example, you can go on to Google Search Console and find out how many pages have been crawled by Google itself. You want to have as few redirect chains as possible. And in essence, it's like moving house. You want your mail to be placed from your old property to your new property. But if you don't tell search engines you've moved, you've redirected, and actually you've moved several times throughout the years, they will actually give up at some point, just as a mail person would posting mail to your house. This is known as a redirect loop. You want to have as few of these as possible. Not only is it annoying to the search engine, it equally is irritating for the user. User experience ranking factors, things like site speed, distinct from page speed. A lot of people, when they look at site speed, are actually looking at page speed. That's to say, you're looking at the page speed of a particular page on your website, or maybe just up to 10 at a time. You want to make sure you've got a site speed performance report for your entire website so that you can identify and improve underperforming pages on your site. Another factor could be, for instance, broken links. This is sometimes called 404s, and this means that the user clicks on a link, expecting it to take them to another part of your website, but actually it's a dead link, it's a dead page. You want to have as few of these because equally, it's annoying to both the search engine and the user. Indexation ranking factors. Ask your web developer, do we have a robots.txt? If so, is it disallowing any parts of our website? Make sure that you're not disallowing important parts of your website. You want to only deprioritize areas of your website that are not important. Use XML sitemaps. These are basically maps that list out all of the URLs you have, how important they are, and how frequently they're updated. This is also really useful for search engines because it helps them to understand how big your website is and how frequently it's updated. How to get started with implementing SEO audit findings. The best way to approach this is to either look at the most widespread issues with the aim of reducing the most frequent things that occur on your website to positively improve your performance. So for example, you maybe want to fix all of your broken links on your website, then move on to the next factor, which could be, for instance, page speed. If you're strapped for time, you'll maybe want to consider looking at your top performing areas and fixing the things that's wrong with that part of your website first, then move on to other top performing areas of your website. And this will help you to make sure that you're maximizing the performance of those pages to generate more traffic. You're almost done with the course and well on your way to becoming an SEO master. You've only one more video to go. Subscribe to our channel and carry on to the next video, which will cover SEO reporting.